Hello all. Today's topic is circulatory system and the illness regarding to the circulatory system. So what is circulatory system? So before knowing that, let's see about what is circulatory system. So circulatory system can also called as cardiovascular system, and it pumps the blood from heart to the lungs, and the blood that pumps are deoxygenated blood. This deoxygenated blood enters into the lungs and get oxygen from the lungs, and then oxygen rich blood is sent to the heart, and the heart sends this oxygen rich blood all over the body. And again, veins carry deoxygenated blood from all over body, and circulation repeats. So this is very critical process. It is critical system to the healthy organs and also muscles and tissues. So circulatory system is very important process. Circulatory system is also called as cardiovascular system, because cardia means heart and vascular means vein. So cardiovascular system is called as the cardiovascular because of this reason. So what is circulatory system? Hearts and blood vessels make up of the circulatory system. Main function of the circulatory system is to provide oxygen, hormones, nutrients to the muscle, tissue and the organs, for organs of our body. And the another function of the circulatory system is to remove the waste out of the body. So it dispose of the waste, and then this waste include carbon dioxide from respiration, and then other chemical byproduct from organs, and waste from the things that we eat and drink. So circulatory system helps in getting oxygen and also to remove waste. So how does circulatory system work? Getting into that, we will talk about the anatomy of circulatory system. So circulatory system is made up of heart and blood vessels, veins, arteries, capillaries, and then blood, white blood cell, red blood cells, and platelets and plasma. So this is all. So from this, all circulatory system is made up of. Circulatory system is made up of three circuits. The first one is pulmonary circuit. The second one is systematic circuit, and then the coronary circuit. The pulmonary circuit, it carries the blood without oxygen from heart to the lungs, and the pulmonary veins returns the oxygen-rich blood to the body. So oxygen-rich blood to the heart and then body. And then comes the systematic circuit. Systematic circuit, they have blood with the oxygen, and there are a number of hormones travel through this travel in this system from heart to the body. And then comes the coronary circuit. Coronary circuit is the heart arteries that provide heart muscles with oxygenated blood. And this coronary circuit then returns this oxygen poor blood to the heart right upper chamber, that is atrium. And this is all about the circuits of the heart. Then comes the veins, the types of blood vessels in the heart. The very first is arteries, then comes the capillaries and heart, and then veins. So what about the artery? The biggest artery is aorta. Aorta is the biggest artery. It is a thin muscular tube that carry blood away from heart to the body. And then comes the veins. Veins are the blood vessels that returns oxygen depleted blood from the body to the heart. As the veins move toward the heart, their size increased. And there is two veins, main veins, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. superior vena cava, blood from head and the arms go collected from the superior vena cava, and inferior vena cava, the blood from lower part of the body is collected through inferior vena cava. Then comes the capillary. Capillaries are the vessels that are very small and that connect very small number of arteries and veins, and these capillary have walls that allow organs to absorb carbon dioxide, nutrients and other waste product and pass it out of the body. So let's talk about how circulatory system actually work. So deoxygenated blood is collected from superior vena cava, inferior vena cava to the right atrium, and then enough blood is collected in the right atrium, it went to the right ventricle by contraction. So the wall that is present in the right atrium, that is tricuspid wall, closes, so it prevents backflow of blood from ventricle to the atrium. When ventricle is full, the deoxygenated blood is carried from this right ventricles to the lungs by pulmonary veins, and then this blood get oxygen from respiratory system, and this oxygenated blood through left pulmonary veins enters into the left atrium, and then left atrium get full, and left atrium send the blood to left ventricle, and there is a bicuspid wall or mitral wall present that closes to prevent backflow in left atrium. When left ventricle is full, by contraction it sends blood to aorta and left pulmonary arteries. This aorta or arteries send the blood all over the body. So this is how circulatory system works. Now we will talk about the illness that is related to the circulatory system. The very first is aneurysmus. It is the weak spot present in the wall of arteries, and these walls expand bigger and expand like a balloon. So when this spot get bigger and bigger, there is a chance of rupture of this band. So rupture may happen or blood may clot. Then the second is blood pressure, that is high blood pressure or low blood pressure. Both are very dangerous to the body. Then comes on high cholesterol. The fats in the blood is very dangerous to the human. So increased number of fat will be the dangerous thing. So this is about blood fat or high cholesterol. Then comes a heart valve disease. So any if valves are not properly acting, then this will lead to the increase in blood pressure as well. And then the fifth one can be heart failure. So if heart doesn't pump as it should, if it is not pumping well, then there is a chances of heart failure. This is all about circulatory system. Thank you.